Welcome to Charmed Life, a radio show discussing spirituality, magic, and the unconditional love of the universe. Thanks for tuning in. And I am your host, Tricia Carr. We're already laughing here before we get you guys in the loop. Well, I'm going to share with you. So if you were watching live, we are starting late today. And the angels and the universe are just confirming that late is always perfect timing for those who identify with love and the fact that the universe is always working for our success and our enlightenment and our evolving, because as soon as Jarvis hits go and I hear my intro, the time said 11:44. So Jarvis and I are cracking up over here. Okay, I hear you. Perfect timing. And welcome everyone who is joining us in the exact perfect timing. We're excited to be here with you today. And I want to tell you about a couple of things before I welcome my very special guest today. One is my friend Hillary Michael, who is a spiritual teacher. She has a mentoring program for mediums, and it is a program that I've taken in the past, and I highly recommend it. I'm getting a lot of requests for mentoring, and I do a couple of programs, but particularly for mediumship, Hillary is the person that I highly recommend. I do mentoring and for like animal communication, for mastering your empathic nature, and also for just developing a lot of your intuitive abilities in a more broad spectrum way. And then I do advanced versions of that. But Hillary is the girl to go to for the lady, the woman, the master to go to for mediumship in particular. Her website is happycentric.com, and she does a couple of levels. She does several levels, beginner, intermediate, and advanced. She'll take you from just being interested in speaking to those on the other side to being a professional if that is your interest. And if that's on your heart, again, happycentric.com, Hillary Michaels. Check her out. She also does individual readings. And let's see a little bit about what I have going on. I announced it in the last episode that I have a program called Empowered Empath and Highly Sensitive Intuitive, and the enrollment is open for just two more days. It closes tomorrow, which is Monday the 25th. Now, if you're listening to this outside of the live broadcast or in an archive, and even if it's a year from now, just know that I have this program. It will be available again, ongoing, and it is for folks who are sensitive, and whether you know you're an empath or you just know that your sensitivity and your highly compassionate nature is something that you are meant to use here. And sometimes it may even make you feel really overwhelmed and really different from everyone else. And I say sometimes because it's most of the time for for us, right, Jarvis? And Jarvis is one of these weirdos like us. And so that's what this program is, to help us to turn that empathic nature, that highly compassionate, highly sensitive nature, not just our emotional nature, but also our physical nature, and understand how this is actually something that we came into this life with the intention to use it as a superpower. And I mean this with my whole heart. It was the portal, me understanding these gifts was the portal for me opening up to the work that I do today. And not just the work that I do, but to my life being balanced, happy, blissful, truly, truly. Not that I don't have challenges, but I know how to find joy every single day. And I actually know how to quiet that empathic nature, not to where I'm numb, not at all, but to the point where it is actually a tool and I'm not being the tool. Anyway, so if you are interested in this program, it is actually, it's the first time I'm offering it, so it is an extremely affordable rate, particularly for folks who are a member of the Lightworkers Lab, which is something that you've all heard me talk about before if you've listened to my show. The Lightworkers Lab is a spiritual community founded by Crystal Ann Compton, and I am a teacher, a head teacher, and a moderator in this group. I am a guide with partnering with Crystal, and so I highly recommend, if you are interested in expanding your spirituality and finding a tribe, finding a family, please find the Lightworkers Lab on, it's hosted as a community on Facebook right now. So go to, look for Facebook groups, the Lightworkers Lab, you'll be able to find us and join our community. And if you are a member of this community, then you get a really deep discount on my Empowered Empath and Highly Sensitive Intuitive program. Again, enrollment closes tomorrow, so I hope you will join us. It's a live group coaching, really. It's pretty exciting. I'm really excited about it. So now that is the business that I have for you today. Oh, one more thing, actually. I want to extend to you guys that I do still do one-on-one sessions with animals, animal communication, which is really about understanding how you and your animal are functioning as a family. Your animal gives me the insight to how you all are functioning together, and it's really quite beautiful, as well as the perspective of the animal, their life purpose, the things that they are seeing about us, because they truly are well-equipped to be spiritual guardians to us, these beautiful Gaia-centered creatures that we bring into our family, that we create and we choose as family. Nay, they choose us because they are a part of our soul groups, meaning in the pre-birth process, we are working with these souls as well to come down into this plane and to share a love and life and lessons together. So animal communication, and I do one-on-one sessions, intuitive life coaching, mediumship readings. This is all the kind of work that I do, one-on-one sessions for people. So do check out my website. I don't mention it enough online here. On my show here. This is work that I still do and I love very much, in addition to the classes that I do. I have an animal communication class coming up pretty soon. So if you're interested in that, fill out my contact form, because I would like to keep you in the loop about when that animal communication class is starting. It's going to be before the end of the year. All right, so that is TrishaCarrCharm.com. And now I would love to introduce my guest today. She is a nationally certified massage therapist, and her name is Nicole Powers. Welcome, Nicole.
Hi, thank you.
Thank you for being here today. Nicole is actually a student in one of the classes that I'm teaching right now. How is that going for you? You want to talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, I do. I love the class. So I am in the Teachers Development Program in the Lightworkers Lab, which has been an amazing class. I'm learning so much about myself and about the process of organizing content, because for me, being a spiritual being, I like to kind of stay in the ether a lot, and I have a lot of creative ideas. It's hard for me to funnel them down, to organize them into content that I can teach to others. And so this has been golden for that, to think how to funnel that down and really get it on paper and practice it I can present it better.
That's great. Thank you so much for that feedback. It is something that Crystal Ann Compton and I are teaching together. And we're actually going to be doing this program again. We're going to do a few cycles per year. And what this also does is it is, if you are interested in this course, when next time we do it, right now, enrollment's not open on this, but it also equips a person to be able to partner with the Lightworkers Lab and do online classes. And it's really cool. And I'm super excited about it. Crystal, it's like our little love child. So thank you. I'm so glad that that's working for you. That's kind of a lot like the Empowered Empath course. That's sort of about how to take that stuff from the ether in your life and then bring it down into something that is more linear. Because we came in, we are spiritual, like you say, but we're also physical. And the physical is the mission right now. You know what I mean? Like our soul said, it's time to become physical and it's time to become someone that communicates with others body to body, which I think brings us to your expert area.
Yeah.
Would you like to tell us a little bit about your work and your journey?
Sure. So I have a BFA in acting, actually, and I've always been a creative type. But in Oklahoma, I live in Oklahoma. In Oklahoma, it's hard to make a great living in theater.
I'll bet.
But something to do on the side. I didn't want to just do wait tables. So I started thinking about things, and really, it was a God thing for me. Spirit just led me to massage therapy, and I did it on kind of a whim, and it turns out it's really my calling. It's really what I'm good at. It's really what I have a natural talent for. I have many other talents, but I have to work really hard for those, and this one just comes to me naturally. So I fell in love, and I've been doing that for the past 9 years and just really love it.
Oh, that's beautiful. And you work with people very intuitively. And I think I think every massage therapist, every therapist of any kind is, if they're doing their work, in the higher aspect, of course they're working intuitively. Would you agree?
I would agree. And I think that massage school was the first place for me where I felt intuitive at a higher level than just basic women's intuition, or sometimes I would get occasional gut feeling where I felt like this isn't right. But in school, in massage school, I started doing things that no one taught me. And then I got curious, where did this come from? Why am I doing it this way? What's happening? And so my instructors were really instrumental in telling me what some of my gifting is, why I'm doing it that way, and really getting me in touch with the fact that I am an intuitive being. I'm a spiritual being having a human experience, and I bring that to every session.
Oh, that's beautiful, because it's very much like, I mean, I shouldn't say it very much is, it literally is energy work. I mean, you're going in there and you're finding the areas that the body is working to release. You know, the body is actually, like I say, it is our spiritual experience as well. The body is sort of the last step of the journey of us expressing energy, you know, expressing our soul purpose. So when we get something like we get an ailment or we get sick or even we have an injury, that is really our body taking some kind of energy that needs to be off-gassed, that needs to be released. So our being is always working from that non-physical to the physical to help us to learn more, you know, something better about how to become more ourselves.
I agree. And I love how you call that off-gassing. I haven't heard that term before you, and it makes so much sense to me. There have been times when I've worked through something on the mental and spiritual plane, even emotionally, and then months later I'll get sick or I had a terrible time with migraines and headaches and neck problems 2 years ago that were almost debilitating. And I thought I was in a really good place when that happened. So I kept thinking, why is this happening now?
Right. You know,
it could have happened a year ago when I was going through some stuff and it didn't happen. So when I heard you say it that way, it makes total sense to me. And that's been my experience too.
Right. The physical, it follows the non-physical. So it's old news. But then, actually, Abraham Hicks says that all the time. She says anything that's happening right now is old news, spiritually speaking, because as a spiritual being in spirit, everything happens instantaneously. But we have come here in the physical body. We've asked ourselves to honor this grace period where we have the creative experience, but we have to allow it to, as quantum physics shows us, collapse into particles, from those waves into particles. So then on the side of growing or something that is, let's say, negative or blocks or that we want to clear, then it's really old news. It's like, what do you mean? I'm feeling great today. I finally got on track with this project and now I'm going to be taken out. But it's because the body has to release that, right?
Mm-hmm. And I find that all the time with my clients. They'll say, I had no idea I was so tight right there. Or where did that come from? And I'm like, it's been living there.
Yeah.
You know, for a little while, it just, I'm able to find it and release it. But it's a past issue, which I do a lot more than massage therapy, it seems, in sessions. I attract clients to myself who want to talk on the table, who want to process their issues, who want to figure out the root cause of what I'm doing for them physically. And so I've turned into somewhat of a mentor as well through just really building relationship with my clients. And, you know, they trust me. That's a vulnerable, intimate thing. My profession is, you know, I can say things to them that maybe I couldn't just say to someone I meet in the grocery store.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, that's beautiful. I love, it's basically like you are, you're working for both the physical and the non-physical side, basically spiritually counseling them or, you know, life counseling them in a lot of ways. That's really lovely.
Yeah. Yeah, it's great. And it helps me to help them because I can work on the body all day. But if the deeper past issues aren't being addressed, the body has a hard time changing. And the body is meant, it's self-healing. It is meant to heal itself. So not only do I remind the body through touch that it is self-healing and how to do that, but I also have to give them homework to do, like affirmations and different things for self-care, so that between sessions, they can continue progress. Makes my job a lot easier.
Right. Because like we say, it's old news when we have a symptom or an ailment or something. The body is off-gassing that thought energy that we'd been working through. However, if we don't start a new thought and feeling habit, then this is when things become chronic because we haven't actually restarted it on the non-physical side. It'll show up in the physical again.
Yeah, your issues live in your tissues.
Oh, I love it. Jarvis, go, woo!
And one thing, too, the mind-body-spirit connection, you hear about that all the time. And I'm not going to, what I'm about to say is not discounting that and is not saying that's true. It's an and situation.
Mm.
And the mind and the body don't communicate very well. So if you've worked something out emotionally and spiritually and in your mind, the body doesn't always know that it's okay to let that go.
Mm.
So we have to be able to tell our body, I've worked through this and it's okay now. You can release it. And so that's something that is new news to most of my clients and has been really helpful.
Oh, I'm getting chills. That's great. I love that. Yeah. I've heard of the technique before. This is the other thing we do when we have some kind of physical challenge is we say, oh, I hate this cold. Oh, my stupid foot. I broke my stupid foot. I'm so angry at my foot, you know, and now we're rejecting it. When what is ideal is to say thank you to your body for showing me this. Thank you for releasing this. Thank you for bringing this to my attention. I love my foot. I welcome it back in, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And I love Louise Hay's work. You know, she has different affirmations for different parts of the body. And so when something happens, it is a signal. It's a message to me. My body gets my attention sometimes more than spirit does because spirit's gentle and soft, usually with me. And then when it starts getting to the body level, it's a little louder. Mm. Like I notice when my neck hurts and I have a headache. Sometimes I miss signals from spirit. And right. So I do want to say thank you to my headache or to whatever is happening because it's teaching me and telling me there's something going on you need to take a look at and you need to work through it.
Mm, that's great. Oh, by the way, I want to let everyone know we are taking calls 323-524-2599 if you would like to ask any questions of myself or Nicole. Do we have a call? Okay, great. Would you like to take a call, Nicole?
Love to.
Great, let's. Hi, you're on the air. Who's this?
Hi, this is Christine.
Christine?
Mm-hmm.
Hi, how are you? We have Nicole on with us, too.
I'm good. How are you?
We're wonderful. I think we're wonderful. Nicole, how are you?
I'm good. Really good.
What's going on with you today, Christine?
I don't know. I just wanted to call because you always make me feel so much better.
Aw.
I just wanted to call and say hi and see if you had any anything that came through for me today.
Well, you love, what is this? I see butterflies and I see birds. Do you love nature a lot? But this is about free spirit, too. Is this something that you're stepping into? You're feeling very free-spirited? And tell me about that. What am I seeing there?
Yeah, I just feel like I can't get outside enough.
Oh.
Like, I feel so frustrated when I'm stuck in the house or stuck at the office.
Mm.
And if something blocks my plans to get outside, it almost infuriates me. I don't know what's going on.
Oh, well, can you give yourself permission to, so you get stuck in the office, can you set an alarm? And it feels like if you could get out 3 times a day, even if it's for like 2 minutes, and you go out and slip off those shoes, stand on a grassy part, and if there's a tree there around the office that is doing some spiritual work for your for the office and for the environment, and then you could have a little celebration. Can you do that? And set an alarm for yourself, because that's the thing. We need to interrupt. Give ourselves that ticket.
I can. I just feel so I feel so stuck. Mm. You know, when I'm on a project, I just feel like I can't break away. I have like a guilt associated with it. And why should I have guilt associated with, you know, wanting to be free and feel like myself? You know what I'm saying? It's just
absolutely
crazy.
No, I absolutely do see that. I recently got sick because I was doing something similar to that. Spirit kept telling me, you need to exercise more. You need to exercise more, because exercising is like me. When I exercise, I go outside. You know what I mean? And it's a way to ground yourself. And I didn't obey. I was like, yeah, I need to get on that. And then I keep working until it's 10 p.m. And it's like, now I'm starving. You know, and it's too late for everything. But my body then, as Nicole and I are talking about, then interrupted that and said, okay, well, then we're going to have to just get rid of all this toxic and stagnant and heavy and, you know, unexpressed energy. And it's going to have to go out through, you know, in some way that is more of a challenge. It's not true that we don't have time. It's just simply not. We do. We just have to give ourselves permission. That's why I say set an alarm and no matter what, go do it. Here's another tip. if for some reason you feel like, ah, this time my boss cut me off at the pass for me walking out or something like that, go to the bathroom. Close your eyes and ears and do a tree meditation. Take three beautiful breaths. Hide in the stalls. Sensitive people, hide in the bathroom.
I've done that many times.
Jarvis is laughing because we always talk about doing things in the bathroom because no one can bother you there. I know it's harder if you have like infant children, right? Or something, but still. But I would say set an alarm for yourself three times a day, and it's non-negotiable. You have to go do one of those things to connect. You have to. And you can also take 30-second breaks during the day, cutting off those senses, taking breaths. You know, I do this sometimes in the middle of a big crowd of people where I'm supposed to be engaging with them. I will close my eyes, plug my ears, take three breaths, and just clear my mind. And if someone goes like, are you okay? I just go, oh yeah, I was just trying to remember something. You know what I mean? I just something like that. You know what I mean? Like, they're like, oh, okay. Like, if you have no energy about it, they'll be okay with it too. And it's actually really empowering. I wanted to let Nicole jump in here there because this is really her area. She loves to talk about how to, you know, clear blocks by what we're experiencing with the physical body.
Yeah, one of the things I hear, Christine, is a limitation of your expectation. So you have this expectation on yourself, and then when it doesn't get met, you get mad. Well, I've heard that expectations are just premeditated resentments.
Mm.
If I have an expectation, I need to manage my expectation. And all the tips that Tricia gave you are great. So, because it's manageable bites, I can manage to set an alarm. I can manage to step outside for 30 seconds. And on days when you really can't, you know, I had an idea of what if you just plastered pictures of trees or whatever kind of outdoors you like, beaches, you know, all across your office so that you can really feel our imagination is so powerful. I can go anywhere from where I am right now. So if I have, I'm a visual person. So if I can see mountains or see trees, whatever you like, you know, maybe take some pictures into your office, use your imagination when you can't get outside, and then just let yourself off the hook for, you know, you're doing your best, and we're not perfect. We don't do everything right all the time. So let that go. Let that expectation of yourself go. And on the world, if you have an expectation of, okay, well, the world should allow me to get outside more, let that go too.
That's right. And I like that. Let that go too, that the world should allow me. It is us asking. So here's an adjustment. I have two other suggestions while Nicole was talking. If you put some flowers in your office and let them be your companions. And what I mean by that is you turn to them a few times a day and you say, We're connecting right now, and I love you. And, you know, pay gratitude to them, talk to them, and feel them. Like, use your heart, the energy of your heart, and feel that energy reaching out to the flower and connecting with it, or a plant. And know that that's like your best friend. I feel like you had best friends like that when you were little, didn't you, Christine?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, I mean, I've always loved flowers and being outside, and
yeah,
you know, I don't like bugs, but I love being outside. I don't like the critters. And I feel at home at the beach, and I feel like, you know, where I live, we only have so many nice days. Mm. And I feel so, I do feel a little bit of resentment when I plan to have a day at the beach or go walk the beach, because I don't live near the beach. Mm. But when I do get back home to where I'm from, and I get those days, but somebody else interferes with it, it is a lot of resentment. But I could, honestly, I could live in a little hut on the beach and probably be happy until, you know, it got cold, but.
Well, and another adjustment, you know, as Nicole is saying, letting go of the resentment. And we basically, I've talked before about high vibrational questions, because when we ask, we're asking our subconscious mind, whatever we ask it or whatever we're telling it, it will work to manifest for us. It doesn't make judgments of it. It is an obedient servant, basically. So if we're saying, why can't I get outside enough? The subconscious mind is like, here's a reason why. And it just starts showing you, it's basically answering what you asked it to, which is, show me why I'm not getting outside. Make me not get outside anymore is essentially, it's like kind of very literal. And so if we could shift that to, how can I connect with nature and my free spirited interest more so that I can serve everyone else better. You see how that's very high vibrational, and you know, like, so that I can convinces you thoroughly that there is a good reason. It can help you to disidentify with the guilt of doing it. You know what I mean? And it's a kind of like, mm-hmm. it's like an affirmative practice. And also just knowing that we're taking steps to it. So right now you don't have a hut on the beach, but if you can connect with flowers while you're working today, that is a step. You're giving yourself permission to do that. And it's a step toward that hut on the beach.
That's so true. And, you know, today I was planning to go buy some mums, so I'm going to have to get an extra little plant for my office. I think that's a great idea.
Yeah, a plant, because it's more evergreen, it can stay. And then also essential oils, because if you rub a little essential oil on your wrist or something and smell it and just really connect in that way, then that'll bring you into nature as well, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Nicole, do you have anything else for
wonderful.
Christine? Yeah.
No, I think that's great. Yeah. Is that helpful, Christine?
That is very helpful. You know, I was just thinking today, like, the more I want something, the further it seems, you know, it seems more unattainable. And, you know, whereas other points in my life, things have been so easy. And then it kind of makes you rethink, like, am I in the right place? Am I with the right person? Am I at the right job? But I think I'm just focusing too much on wanting something or, you know, finding something that I just need to just... like you said, have an affirmation for it.
Yes, because when we're focused on the wanting of it, the vibration there is actually we are paying attention to the lack of it, and then we just create more of that. So then affirmations and questions along the lines of how can I align with, and then feel with your true emotions that hut on the beach, because it doesn't matter if it ends up being a hut on the beach or not, but right now that is so inspiring to you, and it just makes your heart sing. So just spending time in that moment and say, how can I align with? Because you know that's what your highest intention, that would be your best manifestation if you lived from that freedom. So then there's a reason for it to be something that you will create, you know? So yeah, instead of looking at the lack of it, look at the feeling of it, and then say, how can I align with that greater sense today in this moment, you know, which may be rubbing some essential oil on your wrist
and walking barefoot.
Yes,
staying barefoot,
taking those shoes off and just feeling Gaia on you know, the grass, you know, under your feet. Honestly, even sometimes just cement will work if that's all you have, because cement is still a natural element. We smushed it all together. It's minerals that we smushed together, but it still is.
That's true. Yeah. Well, thank you so very much.
Oh, you're welcome. Thanks for calling. Please do call again. Don't you just love her energy, Nicole?
I do. Yeah. Mm. Christine, you're on the right track. You're gonna be able to do these tools easily, and I think you'll have a better week this week.
Yeah.
Thank you. You just made my day.
Oh, good. Thank you so much.
Well, you ladies have a great day.
You too. Thank you.
Hey, thank you. Bye-bye.
She was real sweet. I like that. Oh, gosh. I just saw her when she was talking right away. I could just see butterflies and birds. I was like, ooh, free spirit, nature. We have another call. Shall we take another call, Nicole?
Do it.
Hi, you're on the air. Who's
hello?
This? Yes, hello.
Oh, hi. This is Roberta.
Hi, Roberta. How are you?
Oh, good. Finally got through. Kind of a little nervous.
Oh, that's okay. We're just having fun. What's on your mind today?
I would like a reading regarding when do you see me seeing my two grandsons?
I
haven't seen them for a while, and I miss them.
Oh, they're in another state. Are they in another country?
No, they're only like, they're in the same town as me. But,
oh, they feel so far away.
Pardon me?
I said they feel so far away, huh? They feel far away from your heart right now.
Yes, they are.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so who is the man that I see that is, is there a man that is the person who is maybe impeding the ability for you to be able to see them?
Yes. Mm-hmm. She is my ex-daughter-in-law, and her and my son, they've broken up a long time ago, and she has a new boyfriend, and that's him that's... trying to keep them away from me, I think.
Okay, so that doesn't really have to do with you as much as it has to do with the mother. And so let's pray for the mother, because it's not that anybody's unsafe physically or anything like that, but it is that there is some unexpressed, some freedom that is being, there's just some weird control stuff going on there. And they're all working through it. And they're two boys, your grandchildren?
Yes, they are.
Yeah, two little boys.
One and a half. 3 years old, yes.
Okay. Two little boys. And so the three-year-old one, actually, wow, he's really starting to... he's starting to take some leadership. He's looking out for his little brother. He and mommy are real close. So, you know, I just want to tell you, it doesn't feel unsafe. It feels like emotionally challenging. And so your son is, what is he? He's getting to see his children just like a couple of times a month or something like that. It feels like a weekend kind of thing. He gets to see them.
Well, it used to be, but not anymore. We haven't seen him in, since the end of June of this last June. That was the only time we saw him.
Okay.
But the other boy, the youngest one, I never seen him for like almost February of last year.
Oh, goodness. Okay. So let me just feel into this a little bit. Nicole, do you have anything? I'm going to just feel into this and see how we can align Roberta with seeing her grandchildren and see what that's about. Or do you have anything you...
I don't right now. I'm enjoying just listening.
Okay. All right. So... I see that, I see you writing like emails. Is this something you're already doing or is this a suggestion? It feels like you have written some emails in the past, but it feels like that is, that wasn't working.
We've been texting and that's about it. Nothing much after that.
Yeah. And so, how's your relationship with the daughter-in-law? Is this something you can warm up a little bit? Because it feels like she could use a friend as well. And you used to have... a relationship that was hot and cold, something like that? Is that what the deal was? So you're not really sure how to move forward with her as well?
Yes, true.
So
it used to be hot and cold with our relationship.
Yeah, okay. So then let's just release all of that hot and cold business and just realize, let's just try to, it feels to me, this is what I'm being shown, is working the angle of being a friend and confidant and really being a maternal kind of support to your daughter-in-law. And I know it's going to take a little time because you already didn't have like that bond, and you don't even have to be concerned that it's going to be a really bonded relationship as much as it's going to be just the common interest of loving the grandchildren. But she could really use some, I mean, prayer for sure. But you guys could, you guys could really almost, this is what it's like. It's almost like, yes, you're family, but it's almost like a business relationship and you having a strong business relationship and you being able to be someone that she can depend on. Whether you have a bond or not, I don't know. That may or may not happen. It seems like that's just not necessarily, it's not necessary right now. So work the angle of the daughter-in-law, pray for her, and offer her support in a way that is very, very respectful. You know what I mean? Like, I'm just here to support. I'm not here to make any judgments, because right now she feels very vulnerable to judgments because she's in a compromised situation with this boyfriend, you know, controlling her and everything. That makes you feel very ashamed when you're in a relationship. I'm speaking from experience, having been in relationships where I was controlled, I felt very ashamed. But I did have some friends that they were older and they could offer me support without even acknowledging the what I thought was a shameful situation of being controlled. So we don't even have to acknowledge that. It's just pretend like that isn't something that is your concern. You're just offering support, again, almost like it's a business relationship, in effort to support the boys. This is what's going to actually help this family come together in a way that is functional, higher function. And if we're able to do that and build this structure together, then that boyfriend that she has is probably going to go away. It doesn't seem like it would be a very long relationship if we can, you know, kind of just work to the good of the children from an almost a non-emotional standpoint. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay, good.
What I want to know is, does she want to contact me and talk with me? Because we're both like mixed communications.
Yeah, so the deal is what she feels ashamed. And she's not even totally, but she doesn't know it's ashamed. She feels defensive and she feels like protective of her choices. But it's really the deep down, what's underneath that is shame, because she is being controlled and she feels like she doesn't, you know, she feels judged. Whether or not you're judging her, she does feel judged. And so that's creating this shame aspect. If you could approach it in a way that doesn't acknowledge any of that emotional stuff and just be a support, that's going to be helpful. She would very much be able to use that help. Okay. Does that make sense, sweetheart? All right, good. Thank you so much. Please call us back another time and let us know how it's going. And we send you love and prayers, and we just surround the whole family with support and love. All right, Roberta?
Thank you so much.
You're welcome, sweetie. You think we have time for another? Bye, sweetie. We haven't time for another call, Jarvis says. We're almost out of time, but we want to take another call. Jarvis is bringing this person on for us. Hello, you're on the air. Who's this?
Hi, this is Joni. How are you?
Hi, Joni. Great. And we have Nicole Powers on with us as well.
Hi, Nicole. How are you?
Hi, Joni. I'm great.
Hi. Giving a call in, seeing if you, between the two of you, have anything to tell me intuitively.
Okay. And what area are you looking at? Is this about career?
Finances mostly.
Finances. Okay. All right. So, yeah, I see you are working. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. And it's a little challenging with this work because you don't enjoy it and it's hard for you to feel motivated to do more of it. And also you just feel like there's a ceiling. Is that right?
No, I actually enjoy what I do very much.
Oh, sorry. Okay.
I enjoy it.
But yeah. There's a ceiling? It's just that it's not providing for you financially.
Yeah. Well, I kind of like hit rock bottom financially. So,
Okay.
And I don't know.
And is there something about considering moving or doing something like that? You're feeling a bit fearful about having to move or change the living situation because of the rock bottom situation with the finances?
Yeah, I don't. Yeah, I definitely don't want to move.
You don't want to move. All right. So I'm feeling like getting creative, especially since you do love the job, but you're feeling some limitations about getting creative and talking to the situation and saying is there something, I don't know if you could be going up in management. I know it feels like the well is dry. They don't have much more to provide. Or this doesn't have much more to provide me with, but getting a bit creative and talking, just communicating with those who are in this line of work with you. And speaking out about it and putting forth your interest and your effort and your needs. It's okay to talk about your needs. It's okay to communicate with others. Does that sound like something you could do, Joni?
I can, to a point, yes.
To a point. Okay.
I can expand a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, even if it's a little bit, just one step, you never know what kind of creative response will come from that. Nicole, do you have anything?
Yeah, I actually do.
Great.
So just a little bit of my story. I don't know if you were here with us in the beginning, but I was an actor first and worked in film and TV in Oklahoma, where that's not hugely popular. And I was very fearful. I loved what I did, but I was very fearful because it's an independent contractor kind of work that money wouldn't come in and that I wouldn't be able to sustain myself. And I was afraid of hitting rock bottom. So I took on a second job, which ended up being what I do full time now, massage therapy. And it's the same thing. I'm still an independent contractor. I still work for myself. And, you know, this time I just had to overcome the fear part of that I wouldn't be provided for. I'm single. I'm not married. I am fully self-supporting. And, you know, this time around, it just was my attitude that changed. And in massage school, I got a lot of skills on how to just release that fear and go for it. Because for me, if you build it, they will come. And so if you love this job and this is, you've hit a little hardship, just trust yourself and the universe that you will be provided for. This rock bottom isn't going to last forever. Mm. In fact, when we hit rock bottom, the only place to go is up. So just, you know, maybe press into your faith a little more and then just accept that you are going to be provided for.
And get creative is what I hear. And that's what I think Nicole did when she decided to do something different, you know, from the acting pursuit and to go after massage school. And I'm so sorry, we are just about out of time, Joni, but I think dig into the faith and release the fear and get creative, whether it's actually with the work you have now and then perhaps adding something onto it or some other interests. And but you're going to get through this. I want to give you that relief right now. You're getting through this. It's not as bad as it seems. And that's sometimes hard to swallow. But just say it's not as bad as it seems. That's a good place to start to know that rock bottom is actually going straight up. All right, sweetie?
Awesome. All right. Thank you so much for taking my call.
You're welcome. Many blessings to you.
All right. Have a great day, guys. All right. Bye-bye.
And we are out of time, but Nicole, could you please let everyone know how they can get in touch with you?
I'd love to. So if you're ever in Oklahoma, come see me. You can find me on Facebook. My page, if you search at Blue Sky Nicole in the search bar, you'll find my business page, which is right now called Massage Therapy by Nicole. That name may change as I start to add some other things to my business, but just go there. There's content for my clients here in Oklahoma, but I also provide self-care tips, inspirational quotes. So there's something for everybody on that page. I'd love for you to like it and follow and reach out anytime.
Thank you so much, Nicole. You're just, I love having you on the show. I love all the tips and wow, I wrote down some beautiful quotes from you. The issues are in your tissues. Okay, everyone.
Well, it's not original.
That's okay. Nothing is. There's nothing new under the sun.
That's right.
Thanks again, Nicole Powers, and I'm Tricia Carr. And we will see you next week on Charmed Life live on Facebook at Tricia Carr Charm or on UBNRadio.com channel 1. Thanks for tuning in. I love you, whoever you are.